Do you know what a deepfake video is?
I don't know what a deepfake video is. I don't know.
I do not know what a deepfake video is.
It does sound familiar.
I mean, I would guess that a deepfake video,
when they kind of put someone's face onto another's through like video editing.
A deepfake video is a video that is designed to make it look like someone is saying or doing something they didn't do by using, I guess, AI.
I'm certainly not aware of having seen videos that well manipulated before.
The term deepfake is an artificially generated video of a person in a situation, in a context that was never there. My name is Christy Sisson. I'm professor and director of the photographic sciences at Rochester Institute of Technology.
Deepfakes are really the latest incarnation of manipulated media. So think Photoshop on steroids. My name is Hani Farid, and I'm a professor of computer science at the University of California, Berkeley. Deepfakes have taken, for the most part, humans out of the loop. That means computer algorithms are entirely synthesizing and manipulating the content.
As those artificial intelligence sort of algorithms have improved, so have the videos.
And that, in many ways, is the real threat here. It's not the ability to create fake content. That's not what's new. But it's now that the average person can download some code from the internet and on their laptop synthesize very compelling fake videos, fake images, and fake audios.
The genie's out of the bottle, so to speak. This is not something that is in the research world. This is something that's definitely out there and being used.
For there to be technology that where we can't tell if a politician is really saying it or if it's a doctored video, then I have no idea how anyone is going to be able to get the news.
And that's a worrying trend, because if we move in a direction where we can't believe what we read, see, and hear online, how do you have, for example, a democracy?
I do think that a last-minute deepfake could have an effect on how people vote.
If you can literally put words in someone's mouth, then it's completely dangerous.
Think about the power of that technology when it comes to world leaders, CEOs, military leaders, people running for office. It's incredibly powerful.
Somebody who has an agenda can disseminate information that can spread far more quickly than the catch-up of, yes, this has been debunked, yes, this is fake.
Once that information gets out there, it's gonna be too late, and then it's already gone viral, the information has already spread.
You don't have to fool 100% of the people 100% of the time.
People tend to believe things that support what they already believe, even if there's good evidence against that belief.
Understand that the margins in elections are incredibly thin. You have to swing 100,000 votes. That's the ball game. You don't have to swing 100 million votes.
So once it's out there, it's the damage is there, and it sometimes can't be repaired.
We have to get a handle on this issue, because I think it really, these are existential threats to our democracy. So what do? We can just throw our hands up and say, well, that's the way the world is. But I don't think that's a good answer. We have to get better at developing technology that can help you as a citizen say, this is fake, this is real. This is trusted, this is not trusted. We have to do better on that.
We have the problem with misinformation being shared, even if it's not very convincing. So there's a much deeper issue at work.
I know it's easy to be overwhelmed by the landscape, but here are some things for you to think about. One, slow down and don't be so quick to share. Wait a minute, wait 2 minutes and think about what you're doing.
Just taking that moment and applying a little bit of skepticism to those images and videos can make a huge difference.
While your voice is relatively small on the internet, it is a voice. It may seem that whether you share or not doesn't make a difference. What's the difference between your voice and 2 billion other voices out there? But in the same way that it matters that you vote, these things matter.
Second, let's admit we're being manipulated. There are individuals who are creating content in order to manipulate us, in order to get us to think a certain way.
The scales aren't balanced on the internet. The adversary who is trying to fool you, whether it's for political reasons or economic reasons, is incredibly committed.
So all the more reason to take that moment and before you share.
Number three, and this one is hard, is become critical but not cynical.
Being skeptical is healthy. Looking at your sources, finding out where that image came from.
There's a lot of information out there, and your responsibility is to consume as much as possible to make an informed decision. It may never be perfect, but you gotta at least make the effort. Resist the temptation to think that you actually know what's going on. Understand what you do not know. That's at least as important as understanding what you do know.
So lastly, scale back on social media as your main source of news.
It is not a place to get your news. You have to start understanding that and start figuring out where do you get trusted news.
Social media is a really easy place to get an information dump really quickly, but it's not the best place to get really critical information from.
The world is complex, the issues are complex, and we have to stop pretending that we can understand the world in 140 or 280 characters. I understand that it's complicated, but we are more than happy to sit down 4 hours on end and watch mindless YouTube videos. Take a fraction of that time and read the article, engage on the facts before you draw the conclusion.
So regardless of what sort of political bent that image or that video should have, to try to do our due diligence to be informed media consumers. Because the alternative is really dangerous.
I think the voter's responsibility as a general population is just to make sure that the information you're getting is correct.
I think it's the responsibility of social media users to do their best to be honest about what they're posting and sharing.
The average person on the internet downloading some code from the internet is not gonna create a perfect fake. But a highly dedicated group of technical people, they are probably within 6 months of creating essentially imperceptible fakes. Every few months when I see some of the good fakes coming out on YouTube, my students and I are in awe of how good they are.
This problem is much bigger than technology. It's much bigger than the improvement of these technologies.
You have to probably dig a little deeper in some of the topics that are being talked about to make sure that they're fact and not alternative facts.
We need to do our own critical thinking and not take everything for face value.
It's not so much seeing is believing as it is I believed first and then I saw it, and it's gonna be very tough to convince me otherwise.
I'd like to say that I'm putting forth more effort to get a little bit more knowledge on the subject so that I can participate more.